Sanjay Gupta, MD, CNN Sunday Morning, 7:30 Eastern.
Linus Pauling supported this way back when. This was a man who won 2 Nobel Prizes, okay. So you had the weight of a Nobel Prize winner behind you. Two, there was a cover on Time magazine that said vitamins could be the answer to aging, to cancer, to heart disease. Now we know that the opposite is true. And you know, when the FDA tried to regulate this, because they were worried that there was no safety record on these large doses of vitamins, they were defeated by a very powerful, politically influential industry. And ultimately, consumers now are in a position where they don't know something that they should know. You know, I think if vitamins were a regulated industry, you could argue that megavitamins would have a black box warning on them, given all these studies. There's 20 studies that show that too much vitamins can actually shorten your life.
And people aren't beating the drum on this. Why? Is this a too many financial competing interests? Or why are people going to hear this from you for the first time?
I think if we read the medical literature, they wouldn't be hearing it from me for the first time. In fact, when there were two studies, once they were a month apart, I think, and then the Wall Street Journal had a headline that said, "Is this the end of popping vitamins?" And in that article, there was a quote from the president of the GNC Corporation where he said, "We just let these studies pass. This doesn't affect our business," because he knows that he's got marketing behind him and he's able to market things as being safe at some level, because the FDA really isn't responsible for looking over his shoulder.
So what is someone to do? And if you would tell me, what do you do? I mean, do you take vitamins? What would you advise the average consumer?
Not anymore. After I started doing
this
reading, I stopped. I was used to take one Centrum Silver a day. I don't think I need that. I think I get that in what I eat. But I don't think that would hurt me. I just think that I don't really need it. But certainly the megavitamins is something you should absolutely avoid. It amazes me, actually, that we don't know this. I mean, were this a regulated industry, we would know it, but we don't, and it's sad. So, for example, when Vioxx was found to be to increase one's risk of heart disease by twofold if you took a fairly high amount of Vioxx for 18 months, we knew about that in a second. I mean, Vioxx became synonymous with the word poison, I think, for some people, because the FDA regulated it. They put out a media release. It became very clear that this was a problem, and ultimately the company that made it took it off the market. Vitamins have, if you look at the data on megavitamins, large doses of vitamins, I think it's worse than Vioxx, and yet we don't know about it because the industry knows that it can market that away, that unless people are reading the journals, they're not going to know about it.
Vitamins could be worse than Vioxx.
Yeah, that's right.